Let's go down a list of currently some vaccines that are available today. You just mentioned one, doctor, which was the killed inactivated vaccine. Let's take the first one.
Yep. So a live vaccine, a live virus vaccine, has a little bit of a weakened virus in it. And a good example of that would be the chickenpox vaccine or varicella. The killed or inactivated vaccines have a component of the germ, and it's not a live virus or bacteria. And a good example of that would be the flu vaccine, which we just talked about. Toxoid vaccines are another type of vaccine where basically it's not actually the germ, but a toxin or a chemical that the germ makes that makes people ill. So that vaccine, a good example of that is the tetanus vaccine, which protects us. And we'll be talking about that one a little bit more later. And finally, a biosynthetic vaccine is the fourth type of vaccine. And that's a man-made vaccine that creates substances that resemble infectious diseases to protect our body. So it kind of triggers our body to making antibodies. And the hepatitis B vaccine is an example of that.
All right. And the hepatitis B is really important, isn't it?
Yes. Yes, it is.
Why so?
Hepatitis B is a virus that can affect the liver, and it can cause chronic liver disease as well. It is preventable. And so that's why the vaccine is very important. It is given at birth and then a childhood immunity series. It is also spread by contact with blood, semen, body fluids. And so certainly healthcare workers, anybody who may be in contact should be vaccinated.